My name is Bharat Banga. Currently, I am working as a consultant in banking, and currently I am preparing for the Python. And I want to work in an IT field, so I want to grow in this field. And so my preparation is goes on Python. On this basis, I want to work on the new skills regarding the Python. And next, I will improve myself in the field of IT. So okay. That's why this is my goal. And currently, I am doing myself as a to grow my skill in for the IT.
What is the latest version of Python?
The latest version of Python is 3.9.
Okay. 3.9.2 or 3.9?
3.9.2.
Okay. Are you sure about it?
Yes, sir. Currently, I am running this version, and if updated is so, I not know about this.
Okay. What is Python interpreter?
The Python interpreter is the interpreter that run the your program in the live or that any process. So it is not a like a compiler. It is inbuilt interpreter in the Python language. So the use of interpreter, the Python run line by line, but in case of compiler, the program run on the whole process.
Okay, means interpreter will execute the program line by line. Python is platform independent or platform dependent script?
This is platform independent script. First name.
Okay. Can we create desktop applications using Python?
Yes, sir. We can create desktop and web other web version also for this.
Okay. Python supports switch statement.
Switch statement.
Yes.
Sure,
okay, what is the work of pass keyword in Python?
For the pass keyword, suppose if program is running, if we want to ignore a line, for that we use pass keyword, then program will run from next line. So this is the use of pass keyword.
What is the difference between break and continue keyword?
In case of break, suppose if there is a two condition in the program, suppose like x is equal to 2 or x is equal to 3, so we take this condition. If one condition is fulfilled, so program is break at that point and it will run by first lines. So this is the break. And in case of continue, suppose the condition is x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3. Suppose if a program tends to x is equal to 2, so its condition is fulfilled. And at that time, one condition fulfilled, so program will continue.
Means continue will terminate the loop or not?
Yes.
If condition will be satisfied.
If condition will be satisfied, the loop is continued.
Loop is continuous.
Yes.
And in case of break?
In case of break, suppose the loop is not fulfilled, so the program stop at that point.
Okay. How many type of collection object supported by Python?
Collection of object.
Collection objects means I want to say
list yes.
tuple,
set, dictionary.
Okay. What is the main difference between dictionary and set?
In case of set, we take the constant. The variable values cannot be changed. In case of set, if you take the set, the values is constant. But in case of dictionary, the value of key is changing, or we can change the value. But in case of set, we cannot modify the value. Suppose if we take any constant values in the
any other example between set and dictionary.
Set and dictionary. Suppose if we take like a constant, like the age, age is 10.
So I am not implementing this. I am just asking the differences.
Differences.
Yes.
We denote the set by brackets simply, and dictionary by curly bracket.
Set by simple brackets.
Simple brackets.
I think that simple brackets will be implemented by tuple.
No. Both are curly brackets, but in case of set, we take the only the values. But in case of dictionary, we take key and values both.
So without curly brackets, you can declare set.
No sir, we have to use set and that in curly brackets.
Do you know about set method? Set as a method. Set method.
Set method. The method is set and curly bracket. This is the method to declare the set.
We can add elements dynamically in set. Suppose that we have declared set with 5 elements. And in dynamically we want to add another element, means 6 elements. Is it possible in case of set?
Yes sir, it is possible.
How? Which method set use?
To declare the set, there are two type of methods.
Suppose no, I am not asking about declaring. I want to add the elements dynamically on set. Suppose that we have already 5 elements in set.
Yes.
I want to add 6 elements in set. Then what method you will use to add elements dynamically?
Okay, so we use add dot that set.
Add method.
Add append.
Set has append method or add method?
Append.
Append method. Are you sure? Okay. What is the difference between class and object?
The class is that firstly object. The class is making under the object. Suppose if you want to do the programming of any object, so we take for the feature of that object, and this feature is under the class. So the making the feature of object, this is the class, and object is objecting file. Like suppose if we want to implement the functionality of any machine, so that machine is object. And in case of class, the functionality is the class. So this is the class.
Okay. Means if you want to create the class, then without object implementations you can create the class or not?
First we have to create the object, then we create the class.
First decide the object or first decide the class?
First decide the functionality, the class.
Suppose that class is depend on object or object is depend on class?
Class is depend on object.
Classes depend on object. Means according to object you will create a class. You will create class. Okay. What is the default component of class? Means which will be implicitly defined under class. If you are not defined, then also. Implicit block. Which will be created by default. Do you know about it? Default block means this block by default present under the class. We can create empty class and just nothing.
Yes sir, we can create.
How to create empty class in Python?
First we define, and after that we like array, we can create like
nothing else. I want to create empty class. Means the class will be nothing. Suppose that in Java, in other languages, C++ languages, we write class A, curly brackets, opening brackets and closing brackets. This is the empty class. How to declare empty class in Python?
Actually, I don't understand about this.
Okay.
This is the concept of this class.
Okay. So, okay. Thanks for participating.
Thank you.